Good day and happy holidays from Mission Control Houston. There's been no slowing down in space despite the upcoming holidays. It's been a busy week here in Mission Control and also aboard the International Space Station. On Monday, the Soyuz TMA-03M spacecraft that would carry new Expedition 30 flight engineers Oleg Kononenko, Don Pettit, and Andrei Kuipers into space rolled out to the launch pad at Baikonur Cosmodrome in Kazakhstan in preparation of Wednesday's launch. Aboard the station, Expedition 30 Commander Dan Burbank had worked with the biomechanical analysis of treadmill exercise on the International Space Station, or treadmill kinematics experiment. Burbank also continued his work with the preliminary advanced colloids experiment 2, or also known as PACE. Housed in the fluids integrated rack, PACE studies the effects of vibration on particles suspended in fluids in the space environment. This work aids in the development and optimization of crew procedures for the future advanced colloids experiment, also known as ACE, which will fly samples that may have an important impact on our understanding of fundamental physics. Additionally, on Monday, he updated software for the sodium loading and microgravity experiment. Solo researches the ways in which the human body retains fluid and salt during bed rest and space flights. Subject crew members follow a diet of constant low or normal sodium intake and increased fluid consumption. Also on Monday, flight engineer Anton Shkaplerov worked on the Sinner experiment. This is a Russian experiment that examines the oceans below, documents their characteristics, and then correlates that to certain bioproductive areas that impact the fishing industry. Shkaplerov and flight engineer Anatoly Ivanishin then worked to replace several of the panels, fuses, and batteries inside the complex's Russian segment. Then on Tuesday, Burbank spent most of his day working on the combustion integrated rack, which can safely accommodate experiments that examine the droplet, solid fuel, and gaseous fuel combustion in a weightless environment. The commander replaced a fuel reservoir and radiometer in the rack in preparation for start of the flame extinguishment experiment. Results from this experiment, also known as FLEX-2, will improve fire safety designs for future spacecraft and aid in the control of combustion-generated pollution on Earth. Also on Tuesday, working in the Russian segment of the station, Shkaplerov routed cables for an antenna switching controller and installed a space-to-space radio. Meanwhile, Ivanishin conducted troubleshooting on the Ethernet connection of a station support computer to prepare it for downlinking video of the Soyuz docking on Friday. Then on Wednesday, three new Expedition 30 crew members began their voyage to the International Space Station. Flight engineers Oleg Kononenko, Don Pettit, and Andrei Kuipers launched on Wednesday at 7:16 a.m. Central Time aboard their Soyuz TMA-03M spacecraft from Baikonur Cosmodrome, Kazakhstan. On Wednesday, Burbank worked on a laptop computer to convert the Russian video signals of Friday's docking for downlink and streaming using the American Ku-band radar. The commander also spent a good portion of his day scrubbing cooling loops in the U.S. spacesuits. The scrubbing cleans out dust and microorganisms that may accumulate over time in the water cooling loops. And also on Wednesday, Shkaplerov and Ivanishin worked in the Russian segment of the orbiting laboratory, maintaining life support systems and performing microgravity science experiments. Also, to improve spaceflight safety, the two cosmonauts had conducted the bar experiment, which tests and validates methods to detect pressure leaks on board the station. The duo also studied the cardiac bioelectric activity of a crew member at rest in space. Space life science experiments observe how crew members adapt to long-term missions and teaches scientists how to keep crews healthy and prepare them for the return to Earth. Then on Thursday, Burbank worked with the microgravity science glove box in the station's Destiny laboratory and completed some work on the compound-specific analyzer. Burbank also gathered and set up hardware for the EPIC card testing and installation to prepare for an upgrade to computer systems aboard the station. He later participated in an in-flight media event, speaking with reporters from WDIV-TV in Detroit, Michigan. Shkaplerov and Ivanishin had worked in the Russian segment of the station, performing a variety of experiments and maintenance duties. The two cosmonauts also conducted the bar experiment, which tests and validates methods to detect those pressure leaks on board the station. And on Thursday, Shkaplerov worked with the Russian Uragan Earth Observations programs that studies natural and man-made disasters from space. Ivanishin worked with the radiation payload suite Matryoshka, which is designed for sophisticated radiation studies and is named after the traditional Russian set of nested dolls.
The target is in the center, 011 range rate. Expecting contact. We have contact. We have capture.
Docking confirmed at 9:19 a.m. Central Time over southern Russia. Docking confirmed. The Soyuz slides down the chimney at the International Space Station with an early Christmas present for the Expedition 30 crew, a return to a steady-state six-person crew capability. And now you see the hatch opening that occurred just a few minutes ago. Anton Shkaplerov, joined by Anatoly Ivanishin. There's Dan Burbank with his back to the camera as the newly arrived crew members arrived on board to form a six-man crew. Oleg Kononenko, the Soyuz commander, was first on board the Rosviet module of the International Space Station, occupying the center seat of the Soyuz. Don Pettit of NASA, returning to the International Space Station that was his home in 2002 and 2003 for 6 months, and again as a visiting space shuttle crew member back on the STS-126 mission. Last on board, European Space Agency's flight engineer Andrei Kuipers, returning to the International Space Station 3.5 years after he first visited it for 11 days.